Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Tvameva kalo animisho jananha. Ayuralavadi avayavanai kshinoshi. Kutastha atma parameshi ajo maha. Tamajiva lokasya jajiva atma. O my Lord, your Lordship is eternally awake, seeing everything that happens. As eternal time, you reduce the duration of life for all the living entities through your different parts, such as moments, seconds, minutes, and hours. Nonetheless, you are unchanged, resting in one place as the Super Soul, witness of the Supreme Lord, the birthless, all-pervading controller who is the cause of life for all living entities. So what is Hiranyakashipu doing? He is worshipping Brahma as if he is talking to the Supreme Lord. Because he has some agenda. This is not called pure bhakti. He is showing great devotion, but he has great agenda. Not very encouraged in the line of pure devotion. He has gone with some intention to Brahma and is trying to flatter Brahma. And he's speaking the things which actually do not belong to Brahma, they belong to Vishnu. So what are the three things anyway which give us some important lesson? The first thing, he points out Brahma as a life. So Prabhupada says in the purport, life comes from life. There is a book we have written in ISKCON. Actually, it's the title is very important. Life comes from what are people trying to prove? That life can come from chemicals. So actually it is not true. And this is, you see, it is totally reverse. In modern science, the origin of life is something very, very elementary, some chemicals. And in the Vedas, as far as the universe is concerned, the origin of life is the most complex person, which is Brahma. It's totally reverse. Haniya. Totally ulta haniya. Idhare origin of life, some chemical in the ocean. Here, origin of life is Brahma. Most complicated. Uske char sir hai, ek bhi nahi. Four-headed. And huge. Brahma has a massive form. Sitting on a Brahma Loka, the highest planet. And when some people who know the Vedas also and they know modern science, they try to accommodate so many ways. They say Brahma must have a long DNA. Because his DNA has to have a DNA of all the species, lakhs of species. They try to put what they know to Brahma. Brahma is a very advanced personality. He is the engineer of the universe. But in our observation also in this world, we see always that life comes from life. Always. You are not seen, you throw some few stones on the ground and one life comes on. In fact, before to the advent of modern science 200-300 years ago, spontaneous generation was a rule. People used to feel life spontaneously generates. If you throw some dirty things you keep in a corner of the room, rat will come out of it. People used to believe that. That's what actually Darwin also believed in. It is later that Darwin theory was changed by Neo-Darwinism. Otherwise, Darwin theory was rejected very soon. When Mendel and others brought the genetics, Darwin theory was rejected because Darwin also believed in spontaneous generation of life. He had no idea about genetics. Genetics came much later. So spontaneous generation of life was trashed by science itself to come to modern conclusion. And how again they take to spontaneous generation of life? You got it? They used to say if some dirty things are lying, rats will come out, some meat is lying, maggots will come out. That was the belief in the scientific community. And later this was challenged. But today again they are coming back to the same thing. They are saying no, there are some ponds, some chemicals were there. Just like you are doing painting now, paint was there, this was there, and immediately some new living entity came out. They are speaking same funny language which they rejected 300 years ago. Why they are speaking like that? Life comes from life. Life cannot come from chemicals. This is our observation. If you say, so therefore, when we go to life, source, we go to Brahma, it's reasonable. Okay, I've not seen Brahma, but looks reasonable. But if I say, no, there was no creator, no designer, anything, it accidentally happens. Therefore, there is one more proposal which is given, a strong proposal. Is that there is so much information in the DNA. Whenever we have information in this world, either in the form of text in the book or in the form of some inscription, we go to some ancient temples, there is the inscription. Some places we don't even know the language now, but we can see the inscription. What do we conclude? Is it that some accident, some fire, light, lightning, the inscription? We always conclude some person has written. I give a book to you, 1,000-page book. What do you conclude? Who wrote the book? Do you ever assume as a way, kya, kuch explosion ho gaya, printing factory mein book aa gaya? Nobody will accept this. And they say in human form of life only, the amount of information is 3.1 billion base pairs. Huge. This is huge. How can so much information come by an accident? Correct? Now there is one more idea given, just idea. We look for signals of life from outside. So what are we looking for? They put huge, China is the latest now, the biggest radio telescope they put, to look for some signal. And they ask them, how will you conclude the signal has come from another living entities? No, it should have some pattern. It should be complex and it should be specific. Just like polymers are complex but not specific. And DNA is complex and specific. They say about this sometimes in Antarctic areas and all, ice falls. So it forms a pattern because of the air and whatever nature it forms. They say this proofs are, there is no complexity in it. You see in computer they generate various designs and the screen is off, correct? There is no, there is one small formula, there is nothing complex about it. It's not complex. It is specific but not complex. And polymers form, it is complex but not specific. Life, DNA is complex and specific. So there is nothing in nature which shows a detailed information. So we are looking for some complex and specific information. If it comes from the space, we may not know the language, extraterrestrial. But you know the language will be very complex and very specific. Some pattern we can see. Yeah? It will not be something very obvious, very simple. Tung, tung, tung. No. Somebody said maybe set of prime numbers, they said. Something complex information. But we are not getting till now. Or at least if you are getting, we are not able to understand till now. But here, inside a cell, in a living entity, we are seeing complex information and specific. Why don't we apply the same rule? Then why don't you shut up your all big radio telescopes? You are looking for something, a proof of intelligence in some sort of signals. Look at the proof of intelligence. Such detailed information is there. Information always comes from intelligence. This is our observation. Any information comes from either it may be a software program or it may be information in terms of some inscription in a old temple or information in terms of a book. Three examples I gave you. What are three examples of information? Books, inscription on stones, and then third, software programs. So whenever we see information, we always conclude there should be an intelligence behind it. So when we see information in the DNA, in the chromosome of us, every cell, why do we deny an intelligent source? This is a very strong argument to the scientists. Why do they deny? It cannot come. They talk about mutation. By mutation, you cannot add information. You can only change what is there. So there's actually, we have very serious logical objections to it. So point is, life comes from life. It's very simple. So an original source of life is Krishna. And in this world, Brahma. It's very easy that more complex can lead to something simpler. But simple things cannot make something more complex. Correct? Just like I, being more complex, can put down some information. But I'm much more complex than that. The second point was the knowledge. In fact, even Aristotle had some problem with this. And he could not solve it to the end of his life. He said, everything that moves in this world should have been set into motion by somebody. We see planets are moving. We see so many things are moving. Something has to put it into motion. There's a gaadi hai. Koi dhakka lagaya to hilegi. Koi pathar hai. Koi dhakka lagaya to hum udega. Agree? So ultimately there should be some unmoved mover. Jisko koi hila nahi sakta, wo dunya ko hilata hai. And he could not solve it and left the world. Then came Newton. That time true, Newton was also a God believer. But he said, the point is this, we don't have answer of this question. But why we have to bother about this question? Suppose you go to city center and you go to Spar mall. Ab udhar gaye. Ab udhar se ke saman utha ke bahar aa rahe. It's not correct, no? I should come to know who is the owner and pay him. So Newton said, anyway, we don't know who is the owner. Anyway, take the item and go. So Aristotle, being very philosophical, there should be something. I do not know the answer, but there should be something. So now even for knowledge, for the absolute knowledge, there should be something, somebody. And Brahma is the source of not only life, his contribution is also to give absolute knowledge. Because absolute truth is beyond our perception. We cannot perceive it by pratyaksh pramana. Usko to pakadna hai kale shabda pramana. So we have to have an authority which is much more wiser and having darshan of something beyond us. Because within our senses are so limited, I cannot perceive how the universe is created. It's very difficult by my own mind and senses to figure it out. I have to hear it from an authority. Brahma is the highest authority for that in the material world. So there are two roles of Brahma. Now what is the first role? He is the origin of creation in this world. Life comes from life. And is also the source of all the knowledge for all the living entities. Take care? Two. And the third thing comes now in this third purpose. Is that you are unchanged in one place. Comparatively speaking, yes. See, Krishna is eternal. But we, our life is measured. It may be microbes, their life may be few seconds. It may be insects, few hours. And some other living entities, few days. And we, few years. And some plants, thousands of years. Life is, but it is, everybody's life is limited. And Brahma, life is, comparatively speaking, unlimited. 311 trillion years. And then the life of the Lord, unlimited. No question. It is totally eternal. Spiritual world is totally eternal. Therefore, devatas are called amara. It's not amara because they are going to live forever. Comparatively more. Therefore, amrit peeke amar ho jata hai. Aray, amar nahi ho sakta koi bhi. Thoda jyada ji lete hai. Thoda aur shakti se ji lete hai. Is dunia mein amar koi nahi ho sakta. So, in the actually, we all desire. Now, we were discussing this point. Two ways we can take the death in this world. One way we take is, as modern science is trying, to challenge the very design, forget the purpose. That is not the way. I said again and again, if teacher has made some plan, cooperate with the plan. It is good for you. So God has made a plan. Bhagwan ne ye kya plan kiya? All of us have to die in this world. Kya plan kiya? Sabko is dunya mein ek din marna hai. इससे युद्ध करने की जगह इसका पर्पस समझ के पार्टिसिपेट करो उसमें. पत्थर में सिर मारने से कुछ नहीं होगा, आप इस प्लान को नहीं तोड़ सकते. कोशिश कर लो, वही पूरा समाज कोशिश कर रहा है, करोड़ों लोग कोशिश कर रहे हैं, कर लो. उससे कोई आपको सक्सेस नहीं मिलने वाली, रादर उस प्लान को समझ के उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करो. क्यों ये प्लान बनाया है? और क्यों प्लान बनाया है? सो दैट बी प्रिपेयर टू गो बैक टू गॉड. अगर एग्जाम नहीं होता मृत्यु का, कोई भी क्या. दो तरह से लोग ले, दानव लोग, क्या कर दिया भगवान ने, ऐसा क्यों करते हैं, क्या ऐसा बना दिया. दानव लोग. भक्त लोग क्या सोचते हैं, क्या प्लान है भगवान का, अब कैसे पार्टिसिपेट करें इसमें, कैसे पार्टिसिपेट करें, करें. जैसे आपका टीचर है, टीचर गिव्स एन असाइनमेंट वन वे, क्या असाइनमेंट दिया, वंडरफुल वंडरफुल, एंड आई लर्न सो मच डूइंग दिस असाइनमेंट. And when you go to the teacher, say, thank you very much. The teacher will be very nice. Because his intention was for you to learn. You understood the purpose of the teacher. Kya assignment aapko? Dusra jo padhta nahi hai. Jaise aajkal 99% students aise hote hain. Kya yaar, maar diya usne. 10 ghante lagge usko solve karne. He is not understanding the very purpose of the teacher. He learned so much. Usko wo nahi dikh raha. Kya dimag kharab kar diya usko. Pagal aadmi hai. Apni bhi chutti barbaad karta hai. Mera bhi chutti barbaad karta hai. You have a holiday and teacher gives assignment. उसको भी कुछ नहीं जिंदगी में, मेरे भी, मेरे को ही बर्बाद कर देगा. सो पीपल थिंक लाइक दैट, बट ही इज नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द वेरी पर्पज. द पर्पज ऑफ कृष्णा ऑफ द लाइफ इज दैट एवरी मोमेंट देर इज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू एडवांस. वी एक्सेप्ट द पर्पज. एन एग्जाम, डेथ इज एन एग्जाम, वी एक्सेप्ट इट, वी डोंट रिवोल्ट अगेंस्ट इट, देन वी आर वेरी पीसफुल. करें जस्ट लाइक इट्स अ थैंकलेस टास्क. फॉर टीचर्स जॉब, जॉब ऑफ गिविंग एग्जाम इज कॉल्ड थैंकलेस. लाइक पुलिस डंडा मारता, कोई बोलता है थैंक यू वेरी मच, बोलता है क्या, आपने गलत किया, आप रोड में गलत जगह गया, एंड ट्रैफिक पुलिस बोला 500 रुपये का फाइन दो, फाइन दे के थैंक यू वेरी मच, आप बोलेगा क्यों, कोई नहीं बोलेगा, गाली देंगे उसको. करेक्ट. तो सिमिलरली इट्स, बट ही इज नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग बैड, ही नोज अनलेस ही फाइंस यू, डू इट अगेन एंड अगेन. ठीक है. सो सेम वे व्हेन कृष्णा अरेंजेस सम डिफिकल्टीज इन लाइफ, वी शुड से थैंक यू वेरी मच, बट इट इज अ थैंक, कोई थैंक नहीं करता है ना. माया देवी का काम है दुनिया में, भगवान को आने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती. भगवान आपके लिए कठिनाई नहीं बना रहे, माया देवी बनाती है दुनिया की, तरह तरह की त्रिशूल लगा के, आध्यात्मिक आदि, भौतिक आदि, देवी का क्लेश है, ये दुर्गा देवी का काम है. लेकिन जब वो तंग करती है थोड़ा, हम क्या बोलते हैं, थैंक यू वेरी मच, नहीं क्या कर दिया, मैं तो इतना अच्छा आदमी था, मेरे साथ ऐसा क्यों करते हो. और उसको देखो वो पापी कैसे मजे कर रहा है. लोग यही करते रहते पूरी ज़िंदगी, बट ये नहीं समझते कि पर्पस क्या है, क्या पर्पस है भगवान, हाँ, व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस डिज़ाइन. सो लेट अस एक्सेप्ट द पर्पस and participate in the purpose instead of fighting with the purpose. That's why Vedic culture mein ye jaan ke ki jeevan simit hai, brahmacharya, grahastha, vanapras, sannyas divide kar diya tha. Chalo pehle 50 saal jeevan mein apna responsibility aadmi nibhate the, uske baad adhyatmik jeevan mein serious ho jate the. Keh rahe bade bade raja log bhi adhyatmik jeevan ke liye apna rajpath ko chhodte the. To wo accept kar rahe hain bhagwan ka design. Aajkal kaun accept kar rahe hain, use yuddh karo. डॉक्टर लो कुछ बनाओ, एक जीन है, एक जीन है जरूर जिससे ये बुढ़ापा आता है, उसको काटो, उसको काटो, उसको निकालो. एटलीस्ट जो आज में जीवित है उसका तो कुछ नहीं कर सकते, उसके शरीर में करोड़ों सेल है, एक एक सेल से निकालोगे बूढ़े बुढ़ापे का जीव, वो तो हो नहीं सकता अभी. अभी बोलते हैं विल मेक बाय ऑर्डर डिलीवरी बच्चे को, मतलब आपका जो एक सेल ओम कंबाइन करके एक सेल आता है ना, जो उसके बाद लाइफ आएगा, उसमें आपको कस्टम मेड क्या चाहिए, गोरा कलर का बेटा चाहिए, ठीक है, एक जीन बदल देंगे. ऐसा करना चाहते हैं, आपको क्या चाहिए, लंबा चाहिए, हाँ ठीक है, एक जीन बदल देंगे, लंबा कर देंगे, ठीक है. उसके एक्सपेरिमेंट चलते रहेंगे, करते रहेंगे ये लोग उसके एक्सपेरिमेंट. एक्चुअली ह्यूमन लाइफ से जनरली देर आर लॉट ऑफ एथिकल इश्यूज़, इसलिए सब कंट्री परमिशन नहीं दे रही, बट दे वॉन्ट टू मेक कस्टम मेड फाइनली वन डे. बट इतना कितना उसमें मेहनत लगेगी और उसमें मिस्टेक बहुत होंगे, कितने लोग मरेंगे उसके चक्कर में. कोई आदमी आएगा उसमें बिना हाथ के, बिना पैर के, बिकॉज व्हेन यू आर प्लेइंग अराउंड देयर इज अ लर्निंग कर्व. बट उसको भी करके क्या फायदा हुआ, जीवन का लक्ष्य तो भूल गए. अरे बच्चा पैदा भी कर दिया, ब्लू आंख वाला, अच्छे कान वाला, नाक वाला, अगर आपने कर भी दिया, फायदा क्या, आप तो जीवन का लक्ष्य तो नहीं समझ पाए ना. करेक्ट. दे डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड द पर्पज ऑफ लाइफ. So without knowing purpose of life, Prabhupada says, the humanity is ending in unnecessary hard work. Ugra karma. Hai na? इसको चीज़ को समझना आसान नहीं है। जो सृष्टि, देखो ब्रह्मा का दिमाग और हमारे दिमाग में बहुत फर्क है। अकेला ब्रह्म का दिमाग में इतना ज्ञान है, पूरे मानव समाज के पास उतना ज्ञान नहीं है। ठीक है, तो ब्रह्मा के आप दिमाग को समझने की कोशिश कर रहे हो सकता है समझ दोगे एक दिन, लेकिन कितने करोड़ों वर्ष उसमें लग जाएंगे आपको। करेक्ट, एक एक चीज ब्रह्मा का जो सृष्टि है बहुत कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है। क्यों? क्योंकि समझ सकते हैं नहीं। जैसे चींटी है, अब आप इस रूम में चींटी को ले लो और आपको ले लो, आपको जितना ज्ञान हो करोड़ों चींटी को उतना ज्ञान नहीं है। तो हम लोग भी अभी समाज में क्या सोच रहे हैं, कैसे समझ रहे हैं? अरे बाबा, जितना ज्ञान आपको चाहिए वैकुंठ धाम जाने के लिए शास्त्र में दिया, उसको समझो और जाओ। प्रभुपाद जी ये भी बोले कि भगवान को भी ज़्यादा तुम नहीं समझ सकते, जितना शास्त्र में समझाया उतना बस संतुष्ट रहो, ज़्यादा नहीं समझ पाओगे। अब कैसे परमात्मा आपके दिल में विराजमान होते हैं, किस धातु के बने, अब नहीं समझ पाओगे। उतना तो छोड़ो, इतना साइज है वहाँ पे विराजमान है ना, खुश रहो। यस, ज़्यादा नहीं समझने की कोशिश, जितना भगवान ने समझाया उतना क्या। प्रभुपाद जी बोलते थे जितना आपको वैकुंठ धाम जाने के लिए चाहिए उतना मैंने अपनी किताबों में दे दिया, बस उसको पढ़ लो जाओ। एक बार बहुत अच्छा एग्जांपल किसी ने पूछा, प्रभुपाद आई वांट टू नो हाउ आई फेल डाउन। एक लेक्चर चल रहा था, सो वन लेडी प्रभुपाद के सामने खड़े हो गए, आई वांट टू नो व्हाट वाज आई इन अ लास्ट लाइफ। तो प्रभुपाद ने इग्नोर किया क्वेश्चन। दूसरी बारी फिर पूछा, आई वांट टू नो व्हाट आई वाज इन माय लास्ट लाइफ। प्रभुपाद ने फिर नहीं देखा। तीसरे टाइम फिर पूछा, आई वांट टू नो व्हाट इज माय लास्ट लाइफ। देन प्रभुपाद ने उसकी तरह देखा, दैट्स नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट, बट इफ यू एक्ट प्रॉपरली यू कैन चेंज योर नेक्स्ट लाइफ। औरत को समझ आ गया। ओके, करेक्ट ना? कुछ लोग इसी पे जिंदगी बर्बाद कर देते हैं। कितना डिस्कशन लोग कर रहे हैं कि वैकुंठ धाम से हम इधर आए क्यों, क्यों आए, कैसा हो गया, ऐसा क्यों हुआ कि भगवान के संग में थे और छोड़ दिया। अरे बाबा, इस्कॉन में देखते हैं लोग, देखते नहीं देखते, कितने लोग क्या देखते हैं, इस्कॉन मूवमेंट में सेवा कर रहे हैं और टक छोड़ के चले जाते हैं। होता नहीं, भगवान की सेवा कोई भी छोड़ सकता है, बट इसमें बड़ा डिस्कशन है कि, लेकिन प्रभुपाद जी कोई भी आचार्य लोग इस चीज़ पे टाइम बर्बाद नहीं किए, कोई भी चार आचार्य ले लीजिए। क्यों? द मेन पॉइंट इज इट्स नॉट अ इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन। अरे बाबा, आप समुद्र में डूब रहे हो, अरे कूदो ना बोट के अंदर। नहीं, पहले मेरे को ये बताओ मैं घिरा कैसे बोट से, कौन मेरे को धक्का मारे, अरे उससे क्या करना है तुमको। तो सिमिलरली आवर फोकस शुड बी दैट एज मच इंफॉर्मेशन जो चाहिए धाम जाने के लिए वो रिवील्ड है इसमें, एंड इट इज़ वेरी रीजनेबल नो। लाइफ कम्स फ्रॉम लाइफ वी डिस्कस इज रीजनेबल। द नॉलेज, एब्सोल्यूट नॉलेज हैज टू हैव एन एब्सोल्यूट सोर्स, पर शब्द प्रमाण एंड प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण। प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण से काम नहीं चलेगा, शब्द प्रमाण से काम चला जाएगा। एंड व्हाट इज द लास्ट थिंग, कि ब्रह्मा का जीवन आपकी तरह सीमित नहीं है, अनंत। और भगवान का असली अनंत है। श्री प्रभुपाद की, श्री श्री राधा गोविंद की।